One of the most popular methods of making candles today, known as the Alex method, may actually be one of the riskiest ways to make candle. In today's episode, I'm going to offer you an opinion, yes, that's right, an opinion on adding fragrance oil to wax and what you should do about it. Armitage Candle Company, the premier online resource for accelerating your candle making technique and business. In today's episode, we're going to cover the Alex method. The Alex method was created by an employee at Nature's Garden, now known as Nature's Fragrance, by a person named Alex. And Alex declared that, hey, I'm making soy wax candles. I'm having so much trouble getting them to look right. I tried a bunch of different things, and this is what works for me. Now, he was using 464, but he said, I think this works for 444 or any other low point melt soy wax. And there's pretty much only three main steps. The first thing is when you're melting down your soy wax, keep your temperatures below 150 degrees Fahrenheit. What we're shooting for is to just barely melt all the wax so it's a liquid. And step two is as soon as it's a liquid, take it off of the heat and add your fragrance oil. Stir it until it looks mixed and then just let it sit. The third step is as soon as that wax is cloudy and pretty much as cool as you could possibly get it with it not being completely hard, pour it into your candles. But first, give it a good big stir. And at this point, you're pouring somewhere between 100 and 115 degrees Fahrenheit if you're doing it about how Alex declared. Now, the problems he was trying to solve was not hot throw, it wasn't cold throw, it was just getting that candle to look right. What I'm going to offer you today are both the pros, like what's good about the Alex method, and then the cons, like what I think we should be looking out for if you're using the Alex method. I just want to reiterate, the Alex method was not created to help with scent throw. That's thrown around a lot by candle makers as like, hey, if you do the Alex method, I get so much better hot throw. That was not the intention of it at all. Now, does it impact at all? We'll talk about that in a second. So the good things about the Alex method. First, it saves you a ton of time because it takes a little bit less time to heat it only to 150 versus the traditional 185 to 200 degrees Fahrenheit range. 150 degrees, which is 66 degrees Celsius, is obviously a lot cooler. And most soy wax melts around 135 to 137 degrees Fahrenheit. So keeping it at 150 or below is completely manageable with most soy wax, and it's a lot quicker to reach that temperature. The second thing I really like about the Alex method is you're pouring cool. And pouring cool has a lot of benefits with soy wax because soy wax, actually all wax, as it heats up, it expands. As it cools, it shrinks. And as soon as that's in the vessel, in the container, in the jar, whatever it is you're using, the less it has to shrink, the less likely that wax is gonna pull away from the sides, pull down from the top, and cause all those surface issues or bumpy tops that we see all the time. Now, I have a whole video dedicated to explaining this phenomenon that you can check out here if you're curious. Unfortunately, the Alex method comes with a couple of risks. And you may call this my opinion, that's fine. I'm gonna offer you what I have, my experience, those that I've talked to. These are the risks associated with adding your fragrance oil and only heating your wax to 150 degrees. So the first risk is that your fragrance oil may not be dispersed in the candle as much as possible. Let me explain by putting it this way. When you heat up soy wax, you're breaking down the crystals. When you cool soy wax, those crystals come back together to form your solid. If you do not break down the crystals to a small enough size, there will still be some that are left over that are kind of big, and there will be some that are smaller. And as they cool, the final product will have some bigger crystals and some smaller crystals. It'll be somewhat random because the bigger crystals never broke down all the way. Why is this important? Well, fragrance oil gets trapped in between these crystals. And when you have larger crystals next to smaller crystals, there's a lot more space, more area, more places where that fragrance oil can fit in, and it won't get trapped as tightly. In fact, in the worst possible condition, that fragrance oil will actually go down and move through with gravity through those spaces into the bottom of the candle and pool, or it may pool in the center of the candle, somewhere in the candle, it may get trapped. And you don't want a lot of fragrance oil next to each other because that is a fire hazard. Not only that, it's not evenly dispersed through your candle, which is what we're going for with fragrance scented candles. The second risk is it's harder to create a consistently similar looking candle as well. Remember, in soy wax, these are commercial waxes. There's more than just hydrogenated soybean oil. These other chemical components all have their own features and all interact in the wax in a different way. By only heating to 150 degrees Fahrenheit, you may not be dealing with the inconsistencies and the variabilities in those additional components of the soy wax. Meaning, if they aren't broken down or if they aren't given enough heat to expand as much as possible, that can interfere with the final profile of the candle as well. More important than that, though, is the larger crystals that never had a chance to break down may show up inside of the candle, meaning that it'll cause bumpy tops or it may cause craters under the surface that you can't even see. So the bottom line is this: 150 degrees doesn't give your candle the best possible chance of being consistent, reliable, and ensuring that your fragrance oil is dispersed evenly throughout the wax. Because of the polymorphic nature, because of these crystals, it is hard to predict how they're going to behave, but we control that the best by heating that wax to a high temperature to break them down as small as possible so that when we cool, it's great. Now, the one thing I do like about the Alex method, and the reason it probably works really well for making the candle look good, is pouring cool. Pouring cool is great with soy wax because it addresses that problem of contraction that we get as the candle cools. It expands as it heats up and it contracts as it cools down, and that is exactly why it's so important to pour cool. I'm not suggesting you can't even get great results using the Alex method. In fact, people talk about using it all the time and not having a problem. If you're watching this, you're probably scratching your head. You're probably thumbs downing this video because, you know, hey, I use this all the time. I've never had a problem. And that's true. And with that, I'd say the secret sauce in that is stirring, making sure that you're consistently stirring that wax to give that fragrance oil the best possible chance of blending in the soy wax structure. Now, all I'm suggesting is that it's harder to be consistent and reliable when you're only heating that wax to 150 degrees because of the very nature of the wax. Now, if you ask me, my personal opinion, always heat soy wax to 185 degrees to 200 degrees Fahrenheit every time, no matter what. When you add fragrance oil at that temperature, you don't have to worry about it burning off. Like we've talked about that before. If you're interested in why that's not a problem, you can check out the video on flashpoints that we did. But the point is, I don't feel good about putting it to 150, and I don't recommend that anybody do that if they want consistent, reliable, and safe results. Now, that's all I have for you today. I hope some of this was helpful, useful, insightful, possibly controversial. Whatever, that's good. Leave me a comment if you have any questions. Otherwise, I hope you have a great week. I hope you make beautiful, safe candles, and I will see you in the next episode.